Good morning, children. Children, we have completed the explanation part of reproduction in plants, and now we will do the exercises of the same. So the first one, that is the A part, is fill in the blanks. Part A is fill in the blanks, and the first question is dash reproduce through the process of budding. Yeast reproduces through the process of budding. Now the second question is pollen grains are produced by anther. It will be anther. Third one is the agents that carry the pollen grains from anther to a stigma are called, they are known as pollinators, which carry the pollen grains from the anther to the stigma. It is pollinators. Now fourth one is the fusion of a male gamete with a female gamete is known as, the process is known as fertilization. It is fertilization. Fifth and last, seeds of orchids get dispersed by wind because they are lighter. They are light-weighted, that's why they get dispersed by wind. Now, the B part, it is true or false. So, first one is yeast reproduces asexually through fragmentation. It is wrong because it reproduces asexually through budding process, not fragmentation. So, first one will be false. Second one, sweet potato and dahlia use their roots for asexual reproduction. Yes, they use their roots for asexual reproduction. We had already studied, isn't it? So the statement is correct, true. Third one is a unisexual flower has both stamen and pistil in it. It is completely wrong because unisexual has only one, either male or female. That is, either it is having stamen or pistil in it. Both is having in which? It is having in bisexual flowers. So it will be false. Now fourth one is water can be an agent of pollination. Yes, water is an agent of pollination because the seeds which are supposed to float in water get dispersed by and gets pollinated by water. That is, water serves as an agent of pollination. So it is true. Now, fifth and last, male and female gametes fuse to form the zygote. Yes, it is correct. Male and female gamete fuses to form zygote. Now, the C part, that is, tick the correct option. The first one is Spirogyra reproduces asexually by which process? By fragmentation. Fragmentation. Yes. The second one is Bryophyllum reproduces through its leaves. Third, the reproductive part of the plant for sexual reproduction is its what? Root, leaf, stem? No, it is flower. The reproductive part of a plant for sexual reproduction. Remember, it is for sexual reproduction. Then number fourth, pollen grains contain what? It contains the male reproductive cells, as it is present in anther. That is the part of stamen which is a male reproductive part of a flower. So what will be the correct answer? Male reproductive cell. Male reproductive cell. Now, fifth and last, fruit develops from the ovary. That is why it is defined, fruit is defined as a mature ovary. So C part is completed. Now we will do the question answer part. Yes, children, the D part is answer the following question in brief. First question is, name the two types of reproduction in plants. You know, children, the two types of reproduction in plants, that is asexual and sexual reproduction. It is given in page number 130. It is given in your book, page number 130, that the two types of reproduction in plants are asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Now, second one, define vegetative reproduction. Vegetative reproduction, it is also given in your keywords, page number 140. You see, in page number 140, it is given vegetative reproduction. See your last one, vegetative reproduction. Asexual reproduction through use of the vegetative parts like root, stem or leaf of the plant is known as vegetative reproduction. Now the third question is, give two examples. You have to give here two examples of the plant which reproduce through spore formation. So it is also given in your book, mosses and ferns. It is given in page number 131. Two examples of plant which reproduce through spore formations are mosses and ferns. Okay? Now the fourth question. Name two artificial methods of vegetative propagation from stem. The two artificial methods of vegetative propagation from stem is layering and grafting. It is given in page number 133. You see here, in page number 133, it is given grafting in rose and layering in jasmine. So the two artificial methods of vegetative propagation from stem are, simply you write down, grafting and layering. Grafting and layering, as it is seen in jasmine. Then fifth question is, when is a flower said to be a bisexual flower? It is also given in your book in page number 140. In the keywords, a flower if having both stamen and pistil, it is said to be a bisexual flower. That is given in keywords. See here. Yes, flowers having both stamen and pistil is said to be a bisexual flower. Okay, Now, sixth and last of the D part, that is, name any three ways by which seeds are dispersed. So, the three ways by which seeds are dispersed, it is very simple. You can write by wind, by water, by animals. Okay? The three methods by which seeds are dispersed are by wind, by water, by animals. Clear now? The D part is over. Now, the E part. Say, answer the following questions. Answer the following questions. The first question of E part is, in what ways is vegetative propagation better than sexual reproduction? In what ways is the vegetative propagation better than sexual reproduction? Vegetative, see here, it is given in your book also. Vegetative propagation is, has a, see here, in page number 134. Vegetative propagation has a number of advantage over sexual reproduction. The plants produced by this method take less time to grow. This will be the first point. And second point, from here you note down, the new plants are exact copy of the parent plants and have the same desirable characters as those of the parent plant. So, 2 points you can write down. The first point is, from here till here, that is, the plants produced by this method take less time to grow, this point. And the second point is, the new plants are exact copies of the parent plant and have the same till plants as those of the parent plant. So, this will be the A1 answer. From here till here, you write down the first point, and from here till here, it will be the second point. Now, second question. Draw a well-labeled diagram to describe the parts of flower. See here, children. In your book, page number 134, this is the diagram, well-labeled diagram of a parts of a flower. So, you draw this one. Okay, now, the third question, how is self-pollination different from cross-pollination? How is self-pollination different from cross-pollination? It is also given in your book, you see, in page number, yes, in page number 136. Here, the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma in flower is known as pollination. Pollen grains are transferred either from the anther to the stigma of the same flower, it is known as self-pollination, or to a different flower, different plant of the same kind, it is known as cross-pollination. So, from here till here, you can write, in self-pollination, you write down from here, pollen grains are transferred either from the anther to stigma of the same flower. This is self-pollination. Or to a flower on a different plant of the same kind, it is cross-pollination. You can write point-wise also. Okay, you can write point wise also, that number one will be this, in self-pollination, pollen grains of a flower reach to the stigma of the same flower, and in cross-pollination, there is transfer of pollen grains from the anther of a flower to the stigma of another flower on a different plant of the same species. This will be the first point, and the second point will be, difference will be, in self-pollination, there is no pollinating agent is required. In self-pollination, no pollinating agent is required, whereas in cross-pollination, pollinating agents like wind, air or insects are required. Then the third point you can write, self-pollination occurs in bisexual flower whereas cross-pollination occurs in unisexual flowers. So these are the three points. You can write that first point is already given in your book. From that here you can write this point. And the second point you can write that in self-pollination, no pollinating agent is required. In cross-pollination, pollinating agents like wind, water, insects, etc. are required. Then the third point you can write, self-pollination occurs only in bisexual flower, whereas cross-pollination occurs in unisexual flowers. So these are the three points you can write. Now, fourth question. How are fruits formed? See children, in page number 137, it is given. Development of fruit. Last paragraph you see. Development of fruit. After fertilization, the ovary begins to grow and forms the fruit. The fruit may be sweet and juicy like mango and orange, or they may be hard and putty like almond and walnut, and the fruit is thus actually a ripened ovary. So page number 137, last paragraph. Okay, the complete paragraph of three lines, it is given here, you have to write. This is the answer number E4. Okay, now question number E5. Why is dispersal of seeds, why is dispersal of seeds necessary for growth of plants? See here in page number 138 it is given. Seed dispersal is important. Seed dispersal is important because if the seeds are not dispersed, a large number of germinating seedlings can grow very close to the parent plant. This will result in competition between all such seedlings as well as the parent plant. The competition is for getting light, space, water and nutrients. All of these are important for plants to be able to grow and survive. So this will be the complete answer from here. That is, this is important from here till last. That is, up till survive, you have to write down in E5. Okay children, the chapter is completed. The exercises is also completed. And in our next class, we will start the new chapter. And children, you note down your home assignment also, that you have to do part A, B and C. Part A, B and C of chapter Reproduction in Plants. Okay children, that's all for today.